The island of Sodor is a very special place indeed. There are lots of different forms of transportation. Road, bus, tractor, and railway. Among many others, of course, but railway is the most popular. You can see lots of engines hard at work, like Thomas, who always cheers everyone up. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the island of Sodor.
Stanley and the school trip. One day, Stanley arrived into the shunting yards at Great Waterton. Diesel was there, and so was the Fat Controller. Stanley, you are to take the children of Great Waterton Elementary on a school trip. You must take them to the picnic grounds. Well, they will have a special picnic and then take them back. Yes, sir, said Stanley. Oh, Stanley, you're taking the children? Gruffed Diesel. I am. It's going to be a very exciting day. No, it won't if you mess up. If you mess up on the way to the picnic ground, while you're at the picnic ground, or even picking up the children, said Diesel. Be careful, he teased. Don't worry about me, said Stanley. I can do it. Don't be too full of yourself, oil Diesel. Oh, no, said Stanley. What if Diesel is right? What if I do mess up? Stanley arrived to the yards to pick up his coaches. Hello, Stanley. The Fat Controller says you can take Annie and Clarabelle. Wouldn't you get upset like you did when I first arrived on the island? I'm over that. I've grown so much since then. I'd be happy to let you take Annie and Clarabelle out. Thank you, said Stanley, sheepishly. What's the matter? Puffed Thomas. Diesel got me all worried about messing up when I have to take the special school children on their special picnic. Don't worry, said Thomas, shunting Annie and Clarabelle into place. You can do it all on your own, all by yourself, just fine. I know you can. You are one of the shiniest, strongest, fastest, and best engines ever. Thank you, Thomas. Just be careful on your way to the picnic grounds. All right, whistled Stanley. And be careful when you're taking them back. Don't puff too quickly. All right, smiled Stanley. Stanley arrived to the station to pick up the school children. Hello, Skiff. Where's Captain Joe? He's in the donut shop. Picking up 5 donuts all for himself. He eats too much. Are you picking up the school children? Yes, I am, said Stanley. Stanley watched as the school children got on board. You look upset. Diesel got me all worried about doing things by myself. Don't listen to him, called Skiff. You can do it. Stanley puffed away. Then he was brought back immediately. You've left 2 of the school children and the teacher behind, called the station master. Bust my buffers, cried Stanley. He had to wait until the other school children and the teacher were on board. And at last, he could puff away. Woo, woo, woo. Bye-bye, called Skiff. Mm-mm-mm. Stanley arrived at the camping grounds for the children's school picnic. The children got off board the train happy. Stanley watched sadly as he watched the happy children getting off the train. He asked them, "Are you guys enjoying yourselves at all?" "Yes, we are," called the children. "We're having a wonderful time." That made Stanley's boiler fill with joy. "If you're happy, I'm happy," whistled Stanley. The teacher smiled. The children went off and played and ate their snacks. And at last, it was ready. Time to go. Stanley puffed away. But without the coaches. "Oh no, not again," whistled Stanley. He puffed back to pick up Annie and Clarabelle. "Next time, don't leave without us," said Annie. We are the most essential part of this train, said Clarabelle. I know, said Stanley. And this time he left with Annie, Clarabelle, and the children. They arrived at the Soda River Bridge. Please stop! What happened, Duck? One of our workmen has hurt his arm. You must please take him to the hospital at once. All right, said Stanley. Duck noticed Stanley was upset. What has happened to you, Stanley? Said Duck. Are you okay? Yes, I am, but I'm afraid of messing up again. I've already messed up twice in one day. Don't worry, Stanley. Fear is just another reason to try harder. Stanley listened, and he bear in mind. Stanley was puffing home happily. He had delivered the man to the hospital, and he was taking the children back home. He puffed into the tunnel along Thomas's branch line, and as he puffed out, Stanley derailed. Oh no! His wheels slipped in the undergrowth and he hung dangerously over the edge. Help! Whistled Stanley. Help us! Cried Annie and Clarabelle. We have to get home safely. Oh, we must be saved, we must be saved, sang the coaches. We will be saved, we will be saved, puffed Stanley. Then Stanley noticed something. I think someone's coming. No one's coming, said Annie. You're overimagining things, said Clarabelle. Stop teasing. I'm not teasing, whistled Stanley. I honestly think somebody's coming. You're wrong, said the coaches. This is all your fault. I'm sorry, said Stanley. I've been afraid. Then he heard a whistle. It's Thomas, cried Stanley. And he's brought Harvey and Rocky for help. Stanley was so excited and so pleased he felt his boiler would burst with pride.
Don't worry, said Harvey. We'll have you out in a couple of puffs.
Woo, woo, woo.
Harvey's crane arm moved, and one by one, Clarabelle, Annie, and Stanley, just like that, were moved back onto the rails.
Hello, Stanley. Did you have a good school trip?
Yes, I did. Now I know not to let my fears get in the way of myself. Remember, said Thomas, fear is just another reason to try harder. And Stanley didn't need anyone else to tell him that this has been a very special, special. Have you ever been afraid of doing something because you were worried you'd mess up? Once, my friend Sydney the Diesel was very afraid of messing up when he was given a very special special, indeed. The Fat Controller told Stanley to pick up a special from Brendan Jocks. But Sydney did in fact make mistakes, just as he had feared. He kept going to the wrong places and picking up the wrong specials and doing other engines' jobs. It was a mighty hassle, but with the help of his friends, Philip, Sydney was able to sort out the situation and get the right job done. The right way. Right on time, too. He was to deliver a truck of wheels to the steamworks for Percy. Percy is a very special friend of Sydney's. Sydney did the job right on time and double quick timing, and he made the Fat Controller happy. Which made Sydney happy too. See you next time.